to another episode of Empowered, Hawaii's Clean Energy Future. While Hawaii doesn't have a single drop of fossil fuel, we do have something else in abundance, sunshine. The sun provides us with an endless supply of free energy, and our islands are perfectly positioned to put it to work.
And tonight, we'll look at the benefits of going solar, see how residents and businesses have made the switch, and discuss the challenges and opportunities of this renewable resource. First, let's take a look at how Hawaii is farming the sun and how communities can help ensure that large projects are done right.
We're in the middle of a very significant growth phase with renewable energy development as a whole, but particularly with solar at the moment. You know, there's a lot of moving pieces that need to come together for all these projects. Part of our role is to help smooth out some of those pieces over time. Aloha, my name is Jay Griffin. I'm the chair of the Hawaii Public Utilities Commission. Public Utilities Commission is a state board. It's a three-member commission, and we oversee all the public utilities in the state of Hawaii. And so these are companies that have been granted the sole opportunity to provide an essential service. So these are some of the biggest companies in the state: Hawaiian Electric, Kauai Island Utility Cooperative, Hawaii Gas, Young Brothers. But we actually oversee 1,800 companies in total, including a lot of smaller motor carriers. We have a critical role both in oversight and leadership and implementation of a lot of the state's various different energy goals. And starting first with the state's renewable energy goal, we oversee the both electric companies that applies to. And so we have to approve any of the contracts they sign with larger scale developers. We approve the programs that they implement for customers to install renewable energy. We also oversee the contract with Hawaii Energy on implementing the different energy efficiency programs. We are working at an unprecedented pace here throughout the state, and you know, we're going to see that play out through the next 5 years. So we've got almost 20 utility scale projects planned throughout the state, just within the Hawaiian Electric Company's territories, and Kauai, KIUC has two projects as well. And so on that island, that'll push their level of renewables up to approximately 90% if they all come online. We're going to see just about a doubling throughout the rest of the state. We can receive community input in a variety of different ways, both formally in the legal proceedings that we have. We have community groups actively involved there. We have public comment opportunities where those comments enter into the record. The commission, you know, looks at the full legal record as we make decisions. A lot of different projects have public meeting, public hearing requirements. So we've, I think, made a more concerted effort to go out to the areas where those projects are being built. You know, these are community-wide matters, and you know, it will have a significant effect for the next several decades. So we certainly encourage people's participation in making their voices known.
At AES, we're proudly helping Hawaii achieve 100% renewable energy future. We have over 200 megawatts of renewable energy projects in operation or under development across the state. Collectively, these projects have the capacity to generate enough power to power the equivalent of 234,000 Hawaii homes. I'm very excited about a project that we have in partnership with Kauai Island Utility Cooperative. We're proposing a pump storage hydroelectric project on the west side of Kauai that's powered entirely by solar and battery storage. Once completed, it will bring KIUC up to 80% renewables, and it will also generate 25% of the island's total energy needs. AES doesn't believe in coming to communities with predetermined benefits packages. We believe that communities themselves best understand their unique needs and priorities. So we're very committed to working together with communities to responsibly develop projects and also to help identify potential needs in communities. AES, in partnership with University of Hawaii, is proposing the 12.5 megawatt solar photovoltaic system combined with 50 megawatt hours of battery at the University of Hawaii West Oahu on their Mauka Lands property. During early stage engagement with the community, we received feedback from neighboring residents that they were concerned about the proximity of the project to neighboring residences. And they also questioned whether agricultural use would be able to be continued once the project was complete. So we took that feedback to our team and kind of went back to the drawing board, and our team was able to utilize a more efficient solar panel, and it shrunk the project footprint by nearly 20%, and that allowed us to pull the panels back away from homes and neighboring residences. We designed the project to enable the continued use of the land once the project was complete for rotational grazing of small stalker-sized cattle, and this provides and supports a local beef production and has the added benefit of providing a natural vegetation management system. In order for Hawaii to get to 100% renewable, the transition must be done equitably, and it must be done with all of Hawaii residents in mind.
As Hawaii transitions to 100% clean energy, local businesses are stepping up as part of the solution. By using solar energy and battery storage, these establishments are an example of what's possible for our islands.
Several local restaurants, hotels, schools, and landmarks have made the switch to clean solar energy. Let's take a closer look at how Hawaii businesses are saving money while addressing our climate challenge.
Aloha, I'm Gunnars Valkiers. I'm the owner and CEO of Maui Kuʻi Estate Chocolate here in Lahaina. Well, this company started as a hobby, actually, in 2013. I was retired. I never thought I would work again, and I decided to start growing cacao. So in 2016, we decided to make a business out of it because I realized how expensive growing cacao was. So my wife and I decided to start a business and give 100% of the net profit back to the Maui nonprofit community. So we designed this factory, and at that time we decided that it needed to be solar powered for a lot of reasons, because the machines are very sensitive to electrical fluctuations, but also just as a eco-friendly statement that, you know, such a factory, which is requires a lot of power, actually can run entirely off of solar energy. And so we produce 176,000 pounds of chocolate in a year, entirely run off of our solar energy grid, which includes a solar photovoltaic array, 300 kilowatts that covers the parking lot. It includes Tesla batteries that can store a megawatt hour of energy. And it includes a diesel generator just in case it rains for a couple of days and there's not enough solar energy. Otherwise, 365 days a year, 24 hours a day, we're running off of solar energy that's either generated during the day or stored in Tesla batteries. Well, my favorite thing to do in the factory is to eat chocolate. I eat chocolate all day long. Some of it I have to eat to test the flavor. Others I eat just to enjoy them. And so I've actually decided about 16 months ago to stop eating lunch, and all I do is eat chocolate all day and I drink water. I call it the chocolate diet. And I haven't gained weight from it. In fact, my blood chemistries are as good as they have ever been, which is a great thing. I'm 69 years old now, and you know, sort of getting toward the last part of my life. And you know, I want to create a legacy of some sort. So we have a family foundation that gives back to the community. The mission of the company is to give back to the community. And being solar self-sufficient is another way of giving back to the community. It's a demonstration, first of all, that it can be done. You know, it is expensive in the beginning to build it, but it pays for itself over a short period of time. So, you know, it's an example, I think, of leadership that enables other people to say, hey, I can do that too.
I Hawaiian started in 1947 by my grandparents, and it's remained a family business three generations later. I think anybody in the restaurant business will tell you that running a restaurant is very hard work, but definitely our multi-generational customers, the relationships that we have built over the past 74 years, those relationships are, you know, are a lifetime of memories. It's so hard because every day you hear in the news climate change is happening, and you understand, you know, that this is something that is real. It's not made up, and it really requires each one of us to contribute and do our part. This is not just a Hawaii problem. This is, you know, a global problem. So whatever little part that we can do individually, you know, helps the overall goal of becoming a sustainable planet. And, you know, we just had a baby about 2 months ago. We want to have a world that's safe for her to breathe in. And so solar for Hawaii is just, it's pretty common sense because we have sun all year round. And so having a solar project and being able to provide most of our energy needs in the day, and then having our battery backups at night that supplements our energy needs is really a wonderful thing to partake in. And knowing that we are, at least for Highway Inn and our personal lives, we are making a contribution to becoming more sustainable.
We have almost 360 watt panels on the roof, and we have two Tesla power packs. The solar panels can generate up to about 600 kilowatt hours in a day. The whole restaurant on a typical busy day will use 800 kilowatt hours. So we're covering right there 75% of our electricity needs on a nice sunny day. Our electricity bill per month without this would be about $8,000 a month at today's prices. We end up paying obviously about between $2,000 and $3,000 a month now. So as you can see, those savings rack up pretty quickly to our business. What I think the biggest thing for us was when we are moving, we deliberately sought a place that had the opportunity to generate lots of solar power, and a place that we controlled so that we didn't have to work with a landlord or multiple other parties to arrange the power. So what I would advise people to do is if they're thinking of moving or expanding, think of solar at that point. Don't think of it as an afterthought. Really bake it into your business plans, both operationally and financially, and think of it as an asset that you can have, that you can go out and get financing for.
Obviously, you know, we want our customers to remember our food, our history, this place, the story of Highway Inn, but also when they come to a business like Highway Inn, they're also supporting our efforts to become sustainable.
We've tried as best we can as a restaurant to incorporate, you know, many environmentally friendly initiatives from our packaging through to our solar panel generation. We feel great about that. And the big thing about, you know, energy savings and being environmentally conscious and reducing emissions, it doesn't just impact Hawaii, it impacts the whole world, because emissions, once they've gone in the air, they're gone forever into the atmosphere. So we feel like we're doing a good thing, not just for Hawaii, but for the whole planet.
Residential rooftop solar is one of the biggest contributors to clean energy in Hawaii. And for us to reach the state's 100% renewable energy target, every home should be equipped with a solar water heater and photovoltaic panels.
Beyond doing your part, what are the benefits of rooftop solar, and what is the installation process like? Hear more about how to make this solar transition and how plugging into the sun is helping local families.
My name is Paul Oram. I'm the CEO of Photon Works Engineering. We are a Hawaii-based general electrical contractor that specializes in renewable energy and energy storage. The benefits to solar here in Hawaii are for sure the economic. You're going to save money. The environmental benefits, of course, are great. It feels good to be able to make an investment and have it payback. That's something that benefits the environment. You know, trying to leave this world a better place than we found it. So PhotonWorks employs approximately 32 people locally here on Oahu. We have electricians, installers, equipment operators, warehouse workers. Feels great to be able to take these up and coming young electricians, train them how to do photovoltaic.
I'm Austin Boone. I'm an electrician's apprentice at PhotonWorks and I install solar. I was raised on the west side in Kapolei, went to Kapolei Elementary, Middle, and High School. The basic process of installing the solar is setting up the measurements on wherever we're setting up, putting down rails or any kind of rigging for the panels to sit on, optimizers to plug into the panels, the wires to, run the power down to the house, your business. And then we set on the rails, plug it all in, run it down to the breakers, and we're good to go.
To other young people considering a career in solar, I would say go for it. It's going to keep you fit. You get to get outside, work with your hands. It's really something to enjoy. You get to see progress constantly day by day. You know that what you're doing is bettering your island or your community. Get in there, get your hands dirty. It's a lot more affordable, and I think that you'll feel great with the progress you see you make personally.
It's very rewarding work. One of my first jobs in PhotonWorks was in low-income housing, and I could see all the kids running around, and I just stopped and thought to myself, we're doing a good thing.
It feels great to contribute to 100% renewable future for Hawaii. My first solar system that I put in was my own house. I definitely put my money where my mouth is, and we walk the walk, and we do it every day, one solar panel at a time. Over the last 10 years, there's been a huge adoption of photovoltaic, both residential, commercial. Look around Hawaii, almost every house has solar, it seems like, and businesses. It's just a great way to save money, go green, do the right thing for the environment and Hawaii.
Hi, my name is James Aquino. I've been a Kalihi resident for the past 35 years. I was born on the island of Kauai in the town of Kapa'a. I worked for Hawaiian Electric for 35 years. Started off as a meter technician. Then I went into load dispatch, and I've been retired now for 14 years. And now that I'm retired, I really enjoy golfing, I guess because I've gotten a little better. But I also enjoy working around the house and visiting my children and grandchildren in Las Vegas. In 2012, I installed my solar water heater. And not too long after that, I had 20 panels of photovoltaic installed. I've used it to power up my house, and I was so happy with it that I bought an electric car, and now I'm also powering up my electric vehicle, all using the sunlight. The electric vehicle has a lot of room, more room than you think it looks. It looks compact, but I can fit my golf clubs in there, and also take my push cart whenever I do walk on a golf course. I eventually want to sell my 4Runner and get another electric vehicle, and I feel that that's the only way to go. Initially, I installed solar water heater panels to save money. Another reason why I installed the solar panels was I could see the damage that was being done to the world. Extreme weather, fires, droughts. So it made me so happy that I contributed by getting the panels to be less reliant on fossil fuel. I think having clean energy is very important to me because we don't want to continue damaging our world. My wife and I go walking down at Magic Island and we enjoy the sunset, we enjoy the ocean, we enjoy the breeze, we enjoy the people walking and enjoying nature. That's how we think it should be. We want to save this world for our children, my grandchildren. They are part of this. And hopefully they can continue the trend that we are starting to set for them.
The abundant sunshine is one of the many reasons Hawaii is considered paradise to so many. And as we've learned tonight, the free fuel the sun provides will power our island's future.
And that's good news, not only for our keiki, but for our economy as well. Until next time, aloha.
We hope you enjoyed tonight's episode of Empowered. Blue Planet Foundation is committed to accelerating Hawaii's clean energy future through bold policy, creative storytelling, and impactful programs. Our work as a public charity is largely supported through the generosity of individuals. To join our journey to 100% clean energy in Hawaii, please visit blueplanetfoundation.org to make a contribution today. Mahalo.